Hey, what's going on? So in today's video, I want to answer a question that I've seen a lot, especially recently. Coaches have been emailing me this, and I knew that I needed to come and make a video here to show you everything from A to Z. And the question is, hey, Ben, how much does it cost to start my business? And this is a very loaded question, because if you talk to someone else that started their business, they might give you completely different information, but I'm going to tell you exactly how much it costs for me, so you know exactly to the number exactly how much I spent. So if you want to take a pen, piece of paper out, I will be going through the list of charges that I initially had. I'm not talking about the expenses I take on now, but at the very beginning, this is what it was. Number one, I had to pay for insurance. That is something that typically is a yearly cost. So you're paying for liability insurance. That right there is a non-negotiable thing. I talk about it in my book. I talk about exactly which one to get. It's very laid out there. And some coaches who buy my book and they skip over that part, and maybe someone gets hurt in one of their sessions and they get sued, they come back to me and try to tell me that I didn't say anything. But it's in the book. So go check out the Startup Sports Academy book. I give you the exact resource I used, and the one that I still use now. So with insurance, it's going to cost around, also it depends on where you live. I live in Texas. It's going to be around $350 a year, which is very affordable. That is not that much money. That is going to be your number one biggest expense, is the insurance. Number two, you are probably going to need to have equipment, or you can be very scrappy like how I was. The beginning, I had all the kids that I trained bring their own soccer ball. I didn't really have enough money to go buy a bunch of stuff. So I was scrappy. I had everyone bring their own soccer ball. And then once I started to get more money, I reinvested that money back into my business, and I went to go buy soccer balls and stuff like that. I just go to Amazon. Normally that's, you can buy things for very cheap there. And when I did do that, I don't think I spent more than $100 or $150, and I got a bunch of cones and a bunch of soccer balls. Okay, so remember, I kept my budget very low. I wasn't out buying t-shirts, buying websites, buying logos. I'm not doing any of that bull crap. And I know so many coaches at the beginning, they think that they have to have that, and they start losing a lot of money, and then they get discouraged because they don't have clients. At the beginning of your business, the number one most important thing is if you have your insurance, okay, you have that down, you have equipment, you have a place to train at, the focus should be getting clients, not having all these bright, shiny objects that other people talk about or other people think that you should have. That's not the right thing to do. And that's coming from me. I've been doing this for 10 years. I know so many coaches who have gone against my advice on that. They've spent thousands of dollars on a website when they could just like do it for $100 a month or way cheaper than that. Okay. So again, recap: insurance, need to have that. Equipment, need to have that. Outside of that, if you're paying for like a rental space, I would negotiate that cost. I would try to get that down to as low as possible, or I would find a public park. I've been running all of my training sessions out of two places, a public park and a high school. I have yet to pay for, like when I'm training kids privately, yet to pay for any rental space since I've started. Obviously, when I've done camps and clinics indoor, I have done that, right? But the bulk of my business, I've been able to do from local parks and just a high school that's around the area where I live at. And if you follow me on Instagram, you can see those places that I'm talking about, because like, I'm always there, constantly there. And I know that, like, with that being said, you can save a lot of money if you're resourceful. If you're not resourceful, if you just go rent out some indoor place and it's really expensive, it's going to be too difficult to run your business that way. Okay. Now, with that being said, if there's any other expenses that you're taking on at the very beginning, you're fooling yourself. Because I can't think of anything else that you need to be doing that you have to pay for, all right? I mean, obviously, you've set up your business. You've had the cost of setting up your business. You went to the bank. Those are all things I talk about in the book, but you can also do that for very affordable. In some cases, under $20. So that's it, guys. This is a very blunt video. I know that this is something a lot of coaches need to hear because I see too many people. Like, I'm in the soccer industry. I saw a coach the other day at the place I train at. He just started his business. He has a bunch of goals and all this stuff. He spent probably over $3,000 just buying all this stuff. He doesn't have any clients. What's the point of that? Don't need to be doing that. It's better to be scrappy at the beginning and then build from there. I didn't even get a t-shirt for my training business until like 3 or 4 years after I already had trained like hundreds of players. And even with that, that was something that I didn't even buy all the t-shirts for my players. I had them. That was something that they were going to have to buy if they wanted them. Okay. So you got to be scrappy at the beginning. You do not want to be wasteful. I see too many business owners out there that are within sports that are wasting money at the beginning. And if you need any more help with that, if you need the book that I've talked about, if you want to go check that out, if you want to download it, let me know. Shoot me a comment in the comment section here on YouTube. I'd love to chat with you there. I'll shoot you over the resource for our book. And that would be a great way to get started with your business. All right, I'll talk to you soon.